How pleased are you with the UK reception?
Oh, it's been fantastic. It's so great to have a full audience here. It's such a big room. We had, I think, 450 people tonight, which is a big crowd for a cinema, so a sold-out event. So we're really, really pleased to be showing it here, and of course to have so many special guests in the audience as well is something that we couldn't be more than happy about, to be honest.
And how does it feel now looking back on it, because it's quite a while ago? Does it seem more or less real now seeing the film on the big screen?
Yeah, I mean, personally, I've been, you know, obviously living with this film for such a long time. You know, having edited and produced the film for the last 12 months, it's been something that's been very much part of my life for a long time. You know, obviously 2 years ago, or 3 years ago, just about now, was when the tour happened. But, you know, I've stayed with it off and on, and then certainly over the last 12 months, very much in a full-time capacity. So I think for most people involved, it is that kind of, you know, that sort of look back and to kind of get an insight and to remember what the experiences was like. But, yeah, I've kind of lived with it, so it's, and you know, fortunately as well.
And as someone who's a filmmaker but also involved in music, what does music mean to you personally?
It's a good question. I mean, I think for those of us who don't actually make music and are kind of really inspired by the music that is made, I think it's a kind of slightly different take on it, isn't it? Like, I think, and you know, for me, it's a visual thing always, but it's very much a kind of an emotional thing. And I think the emotional side of it is probably what resonates more than perhaps what the technicality of music. And I think if music emotionally kind of means a lot to you, then you gravitate towards it. And that's certainly what I felt with this particular group of people. You know, apart from just being good souls on the road, their music itself was something that, you know, pulls at your emotional kind of heart, if you like. And yeah, I think that's kind of that's what you look for, I think, in music.
And how do you do that technically, either while shooting or in post-production, to actually match the emotion of the music?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's the challenge of the filmmaking. I think that's kind of, you know, to represent the story. And there's got to be a story there, I think. There's got to be something that draws the fabric of each of these, you know, songs together and builds the relationships of each of the different people too. I think if that's paramount, really. I mean, a bunch of music videos in succession is kind of a slightly different thing, and that's probably more a concert film. And, you know, we're probably somewhere in between a concert film and something a little bit more interesting, and we're quite happy with that position as well. So for me, at least, it was making sure that there was a narrative to stitch this journey together, and to ensure that, you know, the audience went along with the experience, not just watching some music.
And it also deals with some serious issues. I mean, Nathaniel's trip home, it was dealt with very sensitively. How did you go about selecting how to put that in and how to edit that?
Yeah, I mean, he was going for a bit of a rough patch, I suppose, at the time, and he's quite a sensitive, you know, chap. He, obviously, all his music is, you know, it's very emotional, and I think that's something that's very true to him. So I think, you know, it's nice when you actually see music that kind of is of that capacity and of that kind of style, and you see a person that actually is kind of, you know, very much aligned with the music he's playing. So for us, it was, you know, was kind of something we had to tiptoe around in terms of, you know, making sure that he wasn't exploited by any means. But, you know, it's not something that, you know, he was just having a time, a moment, and a few kind of comments there. I mean, that's as genuine as anyone can be, I think, to having lost their father. It's not an easy thing. So, you know, I think we were just making sure that we didn't step over the line there in telling that story. But I think it, from a filmmaking perspective, it's things like that actually obviously add a lot of emotion and a different sort of depth to the experience as well.
And for maybe people who aren't so familiar with Communion or Communion music, what would you tell them about why they should go and see this film?
That's a very good question. I mean, I'm certainly, you know, very well connected with Communion in Australia and here and everything since. So I've been aware of the Communion kind of staple and their kind of philosophy for a long time. But those who kind of aren't, are, you know, that sort of experience is, I don't know, I think you appreciate the music. You know, I think that kind of, if you come and watch the film, you get a sense of that these are brilliant musicians and they're also really good humans. And so I think you don't have to necessarily be affiliated with the Communion kind of ethos, but that ethos is what kind of comes off in the end, and which was kind of part of the job for me as well, was making sure that, you know, I knew what their ethos was, but to make sure that it was actually portrayed in that same way.
Thank you very much indeed. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Hey You Guys!
Hey You Guys, huh?
Hey You Guys,
is that from The Goonies?
It is indeed, yes.
Nice. Yeah.